Brother, it's six B's and a lot of talk in the chat. Everybody's excited. I hand the mic over to you.
Sure. Let's get into it. A little bad beats, bad bets, and bad for the books. A recap of what just happened this past weekend. Let's start with some bad beats. And, oh, there were some doozies in college football on Saturday. Utah-San Diego State, first half total, sitting at 22.5. You get a punt return touchdown and a kick return touchdown. Still stays under. Then the full game flies over because of overtime. Dead nuts under game the whole way. Cashes over tickets at the end. Again, two special teams scored. Couldn't get that first half over. Speaking of weird unders, Texas shut out Rice. The one team scored 0 points and the overcast in that game. Texas, a right side winner right there. How about Marshall? This was on my card. Marshall minus 10. They're up 38-21. They're in the red zone in the fourth quarter, about to go up four scores to put the game away. And instead, they get stopped on fourth down, give up a touchdown, give up another touchdown, give up an onside recovery, kick recovery, give up another touchdown, and lose outright at home. Going from up four scores in the fourth quarter to losing outright at home, one play, one fourth down stop. That was the difference in that ballgame. Tough beat if you had the Thundering Herd. How about Southern Miss, plus 11 versus Troy? You get a miracle fumble return touchdown, down 12, and then the extra point gets blocked. It's not a bad beat. It's a bad non-push. That was tough for Golden Eagles backers. Second week in a row, Army didn't punt. Second week in a row, Army didn't cover. UConn gets a kick return touchdown and then a touchdown with a minute to left to lose by only 31 as 34-point dogs. That was brutal if you had Army second week in a row. And Prez, you were referencing it. Auburn and over versus Penn State and under. Came out of one play, one fourth down stop late in the fourth quarter. Ends up being Penn State and under as opposed to Auburn and over. I still don't believe the play call. A fade to the corner of the end zone? Really? That's your best fourth down play? And let's not forget Boise's fumble return touchdown to win and cover. But oops, the whistle. They get the ball, but not the TD. And then they miss the field goal, end up losing outright at home to Oklahoma State. That was tough if you had the Broncos. Another dog day in the NFL yesterday, 9-6 to the Dogs. The Falcons are down 3 in the fourth quarter. You have a TD, doesn't matter, they're plus 13. Then pick six and pick six to the same guy, Mike Edwards, who will absolutely get a Christmas card from me this year. Falcons end up losing by 23 to the Bucs in a game they were down by 3 late. Colts, they got a defensive touchdown, and then they got a two-point conversion try that was tipped at the line of scrimmage and caught by somebody else. He falls into the end zone. Then the Rams settle for a field goal on their last drive, equals a three-point win, not a five-point win. LA minus 4, that was no fun. There's some bad beats for you. What about bad bets? Nothing but Miami Hurricanes money on game day. Canes up to minus 7. Michigan State won that game by 3 touchdowns. They bet Washington State before kickoff. USC closed as low as minus 7. Trojans, hey man, the plane went weird on the tarmac. They were down 14-0 early, and they scored 45 unanswered. All the Washington State money, that was bad bet. Toledo was a 2-touchdown favorite over Colorado State. Bet up after almost upsetting Notre Dame the previous week. Toledo lost 22-6 at home. Yesterday, lots of Bengals money. Plus 3 down to plus 1.5. The three-point margin at the end, well, the game wasn't that close. Burrow was rough. Cincinnati, a bad bet. Seattle money, hey, they were up by 2 touchdowns in the fourth. They lost the game outright. They were bet up to minus 6.5. That was a bad bet. Favorites win no cover. Always good for the house. Cleveland, the Rams, Arizona. And the pros bet the Chiefs early. The Joes bet the Chiefs late. Bet the Chiefs late in particular. That was a bad bet. Bad for the books. Look. It was a game Brian Leonard previewed last week right here on the show. Texas A&M opened minus 27. They closed minus 31. They won by 34 against New Mexico. That was bad for the house. How about the Alabama-Florida total? Opened 54.5 at Circa. Closed at high as 62 at South Point here in Vegas. Land 60 in the middle. Most bettors that bet the over cashed. And anyone that bought back on the under cashed as well. That wasn't a good result for the house. And nobody bet Rice at all. All Texas money last week. There's another one that we talked about right here on Wager Talk Today. The Longhorns win that game 58-0. That was a bad result for the house. In the NFL, bad for the books. Real simple. Nobody bet the Jags. The Jags lost by double digits at home to Denver. Nobody bet the Jets. The Jets lost by double digits at home to New England. Those were clearly the two worst results for the books in Sunday's NFL action. There you have it. Prez, bad beats, bad bets, and bad for the books. Back to you, my friend.